door. Registration number NUT001. Please shift your vehicle as it is blocking the emergency exit.
That's my car!
Get the car out of the road!
All right.
Ahem, do you mind? Let's get on. The next item, due to its complexity, requires a small explanation about... It might be the right seat, but you've probably come on the wrong night. Somewhere else, please.
Yeah, take it somewhere else. This is my
room. At last, I can see the rest of the show.
Oh, stop it if you can't get it. Oh,
no. Not another one.
What do you mean? Another one?
He means another interruption to this item.
Oh.
As I was saying, the next item, due to its complexity,
was the owner of a duck egg blue Commodore. Registration number NUT001. Please move his car. It is parked in a no parking zone. Registration number NUT001. Please go to your vehicle as it is on fire.
On fire? How silly! Hey, that was my car!
Also, with the owner of a hot pink coloured Gemini, registration number TIZ212. Please go to your vehicle as you have left your headlights on.
They then become so annoyed and angry with the narrator that they blow... Wait a minute, that's...
With the owner of a red combi van, registration number something something P732. Please attend to your vehicle. It has just blown up.
Race on me. P732.
That's my car!
With the owners of a blue Commodore and a pink Gemini, please attend to their vehicles as the handbrakes have been left off and their cars are heading towards the theatre.
Thank you.
In fact, it could be the cause of anything around that time which is not certain. Anyway, there is an abundance of proof that Nero has left his mark. Antony has left something else. And we find ourselves in the lounge of something Roman in a year B.C.
How are you, Alexander?
you delight. Come rest my rocks in a lotus.
We have to return to them. For 4 days I was sailed upon the ocean, and I went to change twice a century. Thou wast it well up. Thou art my mother.
I am. Thou art my dear mother.
Right.
Now I'm going to die.
free. Under the Eiffel Tower's where I long to be. Here in Iceland, you had a foresight. You slapped me on some bread with some Vegemite. Eat a sweet finish, children with pickles. Put us on a pizza and we all get the giggles. Leave us in the sun and we get a bit rough. That's what really cheers us off.
Please. don't find the family jewels your grandfather hid, we won't have enough money to pay the mortgage. And we'll be thrown out into the cold, cold snow.
I must see you alone.
Oh, Malcolm, not tonight.
Good evening, can you repeat that?
I have so much schedule. Malcolm, Malcolm.
Yes, my beloved, it is love.
Until tonight, my precious.
Until tonight, my sweet.
Until tonight.
Ghost, he's trying to scare us out of the house. He's going to steal the family jewels.
We must follow his way. Listen, please.
have worked together very in our meetings day by day. They cook our meals on Sundays and they wash our clothes on Monday. But on Saturday we dance the night away.
Yeah.
someone over there. Maybe they can help us.
One for the mean now?
Oh, yes, of course, Zingo, of course, he's Jesse, of course, he has he's Jesse, I'm not
Jesse. Of course, he knows our way with waves.
That's right.
I feel a rumble in my interior. What's cooking for supper tonight? Something good, I trust.
And so tonight, we have roast furnaces.
Furnaces?
Well, meat then.
It is my favourite dish. Is venison? Did you hear it? I said venison. What?
What can be busy, Robin? He has been long away. I trust you enough all the bell with Sheriff, then.
Ha! Right here for Prince?
It's my own Cassidy.
Poor Sue. Tis who's it for? Tis a what Sue?
Tis Robert, and he's horse and lost his shoe. See how he sits upon his horse. His back is straight as an arrow. His legs bent like a bow. Let's give him a welcome. Robin!
Get up, you fool! Let's say it again! Robin!
I've written more. Welcome is the sight of you all. My thirst is great, and I will require a measure of good ale. What say you, Friar? A goblet for you two?
You know too well I can always give a goblet. Gobble the giblet. Have a drink.
Go! Bring me out.
It's you dick!
Oh! The sheriff of Nottingham has vowed to take me prisoner. He says, both you and I, Friar, shall perish at the stake.
You shall never be taken alive, or dead, for I shall guide you with my trusty sword. I'm running through with this. Or thrashing to death.
Where is all me? Where is Mr. John?
He rescued it from Eagle Street. I will call him. Mr. John, come here, you John.
Let's see.
wise idea. Good boy. Quick. Pray, open wide thy road.
Dear old dear, you can't concentrate, that's very
at the moment. Can't you see I'm addressing the audience?
I'm sure so, boss. But I'm so short-sighted, I can't hear that anybody's looking at
you. I'm sure it's sorry to hear that. Tell me, how's your brother?
Oh, boss, I just dropped this here letter with a black board around it. My poor brother is dead.
Hang on a second. How do you know your poor brother is dead? You ain't even read the letter yet.
Maybe I ain't even read it, but I sure know my own brother's handwriting.
Actually, I just got a letter from my brother. He fell atrociously.
Boy, he's sure cleverer than I am. I can't spell that word no how.
Tell me, who are you working for now?
I'm still working for the same old firm. The wife and the six children.
How am your wife?
Oh, my wife is in a bad decline.
I sure am sorry to hear that. Tell me, what are the symptoms of the decline?
That woman, she just declined to do anything I asked her. I don't know. I ain't give her any yet. You know, when the world was made, there was a day over it. When man was made, another day over it. Woman was made, and nobody has rested since.
And so I still thought it would settle some more.
Then they get married. What is marriage? Simply a rhyme with the word tolerated. There is a wedding celebration with rice and congratulations from the congregation. Later on, an increase in the population causes jubilation. Then, as more following rotation, he finds himself in a situation of consternation and desperation till he has to sleep on the floor in isolation, till his life reaches a peaceful termination, and he joined other husbands in a warmer destination from where there's absolutely no liquidation. I sure am, boss. I'm a very musical man.
Tell me then, what is the most difficult thing on the piano?
The most difficult thing on the piano is paying the installments. Actually, I used to think I was clever, but I can play the piano with my toes.
Why, that is clever. That is real clever, being able to play the piano with your toes.
Yeah, well, what about that Mr. Stafford down there? He's been fiddling with his mustache all night.
Well, I think that's enough punishment. We gotta get on with the music. what they're saying. While this is playing, they're humming and swaying.